Ash, taking from Harinama Chintamani. So we know that the three types of names, stages, according to the stages, Namaparad, Namabhas, and Suddhanam. So we generally know about the Namaparad. Every day we are reading morning that what are the aparadas which we commit generally while dealing with our activities. So which namaparadas? So bitaparadas, that name we chant the holy name, as well as we know that next stage is namabhash, and before the stage of suddhanam. So we'll just little brief about more discuss about the detail of the namabhash. So before we chant, actually we chant the suddhanam. So this is the conversation between Lord Chaitanya and Namachar Sri Haridas Thakur. So Lord Chaitanya asked Haridas Thakur, can you explain the meaning of namabhash? So then by obeying the order of Lord Chaitanya, so Haridas Thakur is trying to explain the and different aspects of the namabhash. But actually what is the namabhash? We'll just discuss about it. So as the brilliance of the sun extinguishes the darkness, the holy name extinguishes the darkness, illusion of our maya. So however, the clouds and the mist may cover the sun from the viewer. So like that, holy name is like sun. So holy name itself independently, brilliantly gives the rays. Actually, so but what happens because of these clouds and mist of ignorance and clouds of anardas will cover the full potency of the holy name. So because of this, the devotees experience only a portion of the full effect of the holy name, not completely. So that is why this before reaching Suddhanam, so this is called Namabhash. So then now we'll discuss about what is the mist of ignorance. One is not knowing the actual holy name, position of the holy name. That is first one. So that is person who doesn't know the true spiritual position of the holy name enter into the darkest region of ignorance. We are chanting the holy name, but actually we don't know what is the true position of the holy name. So that itself is ignorance. And the second one is the true position of the Lord. The person who doesn't understand that Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. And what happens when he doesn't understand the Krishna is Supreme Lord, will take the worship of the other devatas and turn to the path of material piety, karma kanda, and all these things will lead to that path, not knowing the Supreme Lord is Krishna. And the third one is not knowing the actual nature of the individual spirit soul. So the person who is ignorant of spiritual nature of the soul, own self, jivatma, and is infinitesimal part of Krishna. I mean, is very infinitesimal part of Krishna and takes shelter of the world, impermanent illusion, and remains attached to this and this world, and is under completely ignorance. So these three types of mist of ignorance causes the jiva to not go to the suddhanam stage. And the second set of obstruction is clouds of anardas. So when we have these anardas, which are like the clouds, we'll call them anardas as clouds, as these are clouds are obstructing the rays of the sun. That is, rays of the sun means here holy name, actual full potency of the holy name is abstract name. So what are the anadhas? We'll discuss about little. Material obstacles. Material obstacles which are compared to clouds. These are classified into three types. One is material thirst for material objects, weakness of the heart, and offense, aparadhas. So these, what are the material objects discuss about? Craving for material objects in this world, and craving for heavenly sense pleasures in the next life, and desire for mystic yoga powers, and desire for liberation in Brahman. So these four types of material obstacles are considered as anadhas. These are the clouds, anadhas. And weakness of heart means attachment to the things unrelated to Krishna. So anything which is not related to Krishna, when we attach to that, so that is also as weakness of our heart considers. And deceit, not having true nature and having something inside and speaking outside something, so which is also obstacle. And envy of someone else's progress. So when somebody is progressing, we are envy. He's progressing, and maybe externally we feel that he's happy and all these things, but inside is jealousy that somebody is progressing, either materially or spiritually. So that is also envy, that is also obstacle. And longing for position and fame, even though we are chanting the holy name, maybe since 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, or 30 years, but unless we have clear from heart that that I should not anchor for fame and name and position, that then this is also an obstacle and as a cloud of anartha in reaching the Suddhana. And offenses, four types of offenses, we know that. So like holy name, Nama Parad, and Seva Parad, Vaishnava Parad, and Jiva Parad. So offense to the holy name, offense to the Vaishnavas, offense to the Krishnas, offense to the Krishna, offense to the other living entities. So these four types of offenses also will as obstacle, as a cloud of anardas in chanting the Suddhanam. So although all these things are there, what are the remedies for? These are the obstacles we discussed. So Prabhuji, we have started this Japa talk a little 2 minutes late. I will take up to 5:12 or 5:13. So what is the remedy for this? So the remedy for ignorance and anardas is, when the serious practitioner takes shelter of genuine guru and learns from guru how to execute spiritual practices and chant the holy name with an understanding of sambandha gnan. So when we take the shelter of genuine spiritual master and follow his instructions very seriously, and by practicing these devotional services with understanding of sambandha gnan, then we can avoid this anardas and as well as ignorance, which we have discussed, three types of ignorance. So, and what are the, still Namaba stage is very auspicious considered. I will just read about this, what are the effects of Namabash. So this is very auspicious. Do not be discouraged that, Namabash stage, still I have not reached the Suddhanam. So, but the Namabash stage is very auspicious. So how it is auspicious, we'll just we'll know about it. So what happens is, this is considered chief among all pious activities, such as yoga, dharma, vrata, yajna. And by accumulation of Namabhash, one eventually gains sufficient faith to accept pure devotional service. Whereas other pious activities, which doesn't give to bhakti. So Namabhash stage is by accumulating continuously by chanting in the Namabhash stage, we will progress to the reach to the faith to Krishna, faith on the Krishna. So then, So what happens? All sinful activities are destroyed and one can attain liberation from this material world. So by an Amabhas, all anxieties and will vanish and peace can be attained. And all diseases also get destroyed when you chant in the Amabhas days. And so all effects of sinful activities already committed will be destroyed, like prarabdha karma will be destroyed. So the many things, like even if you see that, because the holy name is invested with all Krishna's energies, that is why Namabhas days is very important. And so we have to continue in the chanting of the Namabhas days. And one day, definitely, we reach the Suddhanam. Only once we should remember that only if with the pure name only we can achieve Krishna Prema. So remaining all other things like Namabhas days we can achieve. Like material benedictions and achieving, even we can go to the progress to the, by progressively we can go to the Vaikuntha planet. Up to Vaikuntha planet also we can reach by Namabhas days. But we cannot get the Krishna Prema. So unless we reach to the stage of Suddhanam. So Namabhas days is very auspicious. So we have to continue in the Namabhas days by avoiding the offenses. So this is about the Namabhas. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.